Hello, Kimra Hashiv and Jew is Misha Joseph and I'm Pasla Kanan Alaba. Today I want to share with you a poem which I've written about my grandfather. Now, to present this, I've written a sentence here. You'll know some of these words already. Sho can mean here or it can mean this. Dan is poem. Mu is about. And then you have the word, which is usually Thai, which is changed into Hai because of the lenition. That's that H that pops up from time to time. And then you have Mo for my, the possessive. Then you have Hinar. Now that would usually be Shinar. But again, because this H appears after the possessive, Mo, in the same way as it does after the word about, which is Mu, then some of these sounds are changing. Lenition is triggered by various different rules, which I'm not going to go into right now, but it's all to do with letters, okay? It says here, Anan Kilivruani, Kilivruani, which basically is Kilbani, Kilivruani, a little town in southwest Scotland, which was very industrial and now unfortunately has fallen into a terrible state of disrepair, a very post-industrial kind of place. They're trying to make the best of it, but I think there's no work there. It's very sad. And this part here is Shirach in Yerar, which just means Ayrshir, literally on Ayr, the river Ayr. Okay? And this is Shire. Let's just go through this one more time. You should know some of these words already. I think it's just the H that is quite upsetting. And I've written the pronunciation so you can follow using this if you want. Shodan mu hai. Shodan mu hai. This is a poem about house of my grandfather. Mohenar. Anan kilivruani. Shirach in Yerar. Now, obviously, I couldn't translate all of this into English, from English into Gaelic, but I've done another line here because we were talking about trees. Do you remember? We've been talking a lot about trees over the last few days because we were talking about Christmas trees and whether the word for trees should be cliven, said very quickly, or Cruiven, depending on who's saying it. So, about the Rowan tree, it's actually known as Cúrin. Cúrin. So, it's a little bit different. And this here says, Vacúrin. Vacúrin mor na hiesiv. Hiesiv. That literally means, so you probably recognize this here, you've got va, when it's actually the past tense, okay? So if that was ha, it would mean there stands a rowan tree. So we change it to va, to make it past tense. So again, starting with the vowel, starting with the verb, I should say. I don't know where my mouth is today. Starting with the verb to be, va. Okay. You have va kuren mor nahiesiv. There's a little vowel sound popped in there, mor. Because when we finish the ar, it sounds like there's a vowel sound. There really isn't, but it kind of sounds like it. So, Vakurin mor na hiesiv. literally was round tree or was big tree standing. Na means the act of doing. Kind of like saying in itself. Do you remember we spoke about that the other day when we were saying Shematin va ahon, it's a nice morning in itself. Well, this tree is kind of like standing in itself. It's more or less that kind of thing it's saying there. So we're saying Vakurin mor na hiesiv. There stood a rowan tree. I don't know if you know this, but in Scotland, the rowan tree was supposed to protect you from the evil of the fairies and the witches and everything else. And so many Scottish people had these in their garden, including my grandfather. Now, my grandfather, his ancestors all came from Islay. I should say our ancestors, because he's my grandfather. They all came from Islay. So let's have a look at this poem. I didn't translate any of the other bits. I just wanted to translate this bit since we were talking about trees. The rowan tree being the Cúrin. Cúrin mór. You understand what mór is, of course. It just means big. Right, so I'm going to read this through in English and then we'll just recap and then we'll finish, okay? So, in the shade of Grandpa's house, there stood a rowan tree where my brother tried to climb with Rosalind and me. Every day my grandpa came, admired towering boughs, while we as children playing there saw darkened twigs and crows. Shadows hung upon his life with towering darkened power, yet we as children plain could see they were withering every hour. Its leaves held back the sunshine light, its branches stern with years. Sitting with his chair and pipe, it calmed away his fears. Yet we as children playing in sight saw only twigs and leaves, revealing more of sky to us than he could ever see. We pointed up at shafts of light throughout the darkened power, while he preferred the shaded glade to pass the wakened hour. We saw sun and endless days. Upon his chair he sat. Despite the passing years it stood, the tree was sound at heart. And if you like that poem, you can see more on my website, which is josephmactaggart.com. So there we are. So that's the rowan tree, Vakurin mór na hiesiv. The rowan tree was standing. Okay, so just to recap then, this here, Shodan muhai mohenar. And Kili Vruini Shirach in Yarar. Should be quite straightforward. Here's a poem, or this is a poem, about house of my grandfather in Kobani, Ayrshire, Scotland. Yeah. Many, many Scottish people still plant rowan trees in the garden, but I think the knowledge has been lost. I don't think they know why they do it. I think they just think it's a nice thing. So there we are. That's my poem of the day. I hope you've enjoyed this. And remember, tree, cruivin, it's actually trees. Cruiv would be tree. And also cúrin, cúrin mór, big rowan tree. That's it. I hope you've enjoyed this. Marcin Lett, Chidi Andrasda.